fastest game on ice. Passing. Skating. Ring handling. Saves. And scoring. Teamwork. Excitement. Fans. And families. This is the Canadian Ringette Championships.
The Canadian Ringette Championships, they're better than Christmas.
The biggest event of the year.
The competition is phenomenal. People from all over Canada.
It's really high energy. You meet so many people.
There's just so much energy in all of the rinks, and everyone's excited to be there.
It happens every April. 200 coaches, 50 officials, hundreds of volunteers, and families from across Canada. 1,000 athletes competing in the under-16 and under-19 divisions, and the National Ringette League Championships for players at the highest level of the sport. It's an all-inclusive celebration unique to ringette. Anyone who comes to play, coach, and cheer will never forget.
The Canadian Ringette Championship is the be-all, end-all of ringette every season for elite players. It's where all these athletes come together from across Canada to compete for the ultimate title of being the national champion.
Canadian Championships are an opportunity to see how much you've improved throughout the year and see how you compare to the rest of Canada.
You meet lots of new friends from all over the country.
It's a huge family. So you're not here only to compete in the sport, but you're here because it's what you love, it's what you do. The people that are involved, I think it's unique compared to any other sport.
It's great. I don't think I'll ever experience something like it again.
An open concept philosophy is the hallmark of the Canadian Ringette Championships.
As a national governing body, going to the open concept really allows us to align with long-term athlete development. So it allows for more athletes to have access to this wonderful event, whereas before we could see it was a turnover of the same athletes coming over and over again, and others not really having a chance to take part in it.
It used to be harder to come out of your own province, whereas now, just being on that platform, on that stage, being able to compete at that level really creates more opportunities for girls in the game and really get that chance to shine on that national level.
These Canadian championships offer a rare and priceless experience. The opportunity to grow as an athlete and as a person, and to develop even better teams and a stronger sport.
It's a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity for many players, coaches, parents.
You work so hard to get to it, and then when you get here, it's just like so rewarding.
I just love the competition. Everything about it is just amazing.
You get to see so much ringette, like the fastest ringette that I've ever seen. I've seen at the Canadian Championships.
You have to come see it to really believe it.
The Canadian Ringette Championships. Do you want to play it, love it, live it at the highest level? Come, be part of the excitement.
Good afternoon, everybody. You're joining us as we come together to watch the U19 AA Canadian National Ringette Championships here in London, Ontario. Today, we've got Team Ontario wearing red, facing off against Team Guelph in the yellow. These are two of the best teams you've ever seen play, coming together to battle for the best game, for the biggest championship of the year. They spent the entire season working towards this point. Heck, a lot of these girls have spent almost their whole life working towards this. Hope you're ready for a show. It's gonna be fantastic. Team Ontario had an amazing season this year. They went 62-4. 60 wins, 2 losses, and 4 ties. What an amazing record that is. These girls are firing on all cylinders. They made it through the semifinal yesterday. They won an 8-2 win over the Nepean Ravens, where Guelph is no slouch. They've been in the final game of every tournament and event they played this year.
Thank you.
The officials for this game are Brent Bunting from Barrie, Ontario, and Alex Haynes from Kingston, Ontario. Hope they're ready. This is going to be a fast-paced game. The bench staff for Team Ontario, led by Sherry Markle as the head coach, Kevin Dorbecker, assistant coach, Ian Falls, assistant coach. And for Team Guelph, we've got Todd Merrill, Dave Eccles, and Michelle Eccles. Good luck to all. Have fun. Reds flying already, forcing a both sides blue line call. Timo with the first scoring chance of the game, and it looks like the first penalty is coming against Team Guelph. Looks like number 11 from Team Guelph, Emma Eccles, 2 minutes for body. Early penalties can go two ways. Build momentum for the team that kills it, or get some momentum going for the team that gets a quick goal on them. Nobody's really taken control of this game yet. We're 3 minutes in. Most of the game has been played in center ice zone. Guelph has gotten access to the TMO zone now and starting to set something up. First shot on net, Carly Sutton, she makes a big glove save and the ring rolls just wide of the net. Guelph is going to her line change here, just controlling the pace, controlling the game. Thank you. zone. Team Montero bounces right back with a quick scoring chance themselves, but these goalies, I don't think, are going to let anything soft go in today. They're here to play. Both teams are making great use of this big ice surface, spreading out, making long passes, and just controlling the tempo. Quick shot, another save from Carly Sutton. Sometimes those quick ones are tougher to handle than the fast, hard ones. That was Aaron Marco sneaking through the triangle, getting a good scoring chance. There's definitely a good tempo, good pace to this game. This is why these girls are the best in the country, that's for sure. Nice pressure from Team Ontario, causes Guelph to turn over the ring. Keep your eye on the creative passing these girls are making. They know where everybody is on the ice at all times. They don't even need to think about it. It's fantastic. Another near miss from Team Ontario on a sneaky play down low. Keeping possession as the line change happens. They know exactly what they're doing, trying to draw Team Ontario out of their triangle. We have a major body call coming against Guelph right now. Number 66 for Team Guelph is heading to the box, Rose Williams. Unfortunately, she's playing a tough game, playing a hard game. Just hit the wrong part of the girl. When you see the ref with the T sign before the penalty call, you know it's a technical, you know it's a major. She's going to have to fully serve this 4 minutes now. Doesn't matter what happens on the ice. She's in the box for 4 minutes. Great forecheck by Guelph on the penalty kill. Great forecheck. That forecheck threw a penalty on Team Ontario. Tough. You want to battle hard, but you got to make sure you're not crossing that line. That penalty went to Hanya Wyatt, number 6 for Team Ontario. 2 minutes for body contact. And Guelph capitalizes. They don't wait long. Quick shot, arc shot, high shot. Beats Carly Sutton. Lots of game left to be played. That was a quick little shot, quick little turnaround. It was good. A good play all around. Timo needs to bounce back here. They need to make sure they stay in this game. Don't get down. Goals go in all the time. Number 11 from Guelph, Emma Eccles, is the one that got their Guelph team on the board. Gains access to the zone again. They're going for a line change. Start things fresh. Control the game. That was Katrina Hart sneaking through the triangle, getting a good shot. Carly was there. Carly Martin or Carly Sutton was there to make that big stop. Here goes Timo. A bit of a breakaway and a snipe from team number 11 on Timo. Cast speak. Picked up the pass, didn't wait a couple seconds, and sniped top left-hand corner. That quick transition from their end all the way down to the offensive zone is what makes a difference to how this game is played. If you can do that well, you have lots of good quality scoring chances. Volume in this place is so fantastic. Dakota players are not hearing the countdown from their goalies on the goal shot or the goal clock. Shot clock, sorry. It's so loud, so much energy, it's fantastic. Just makes it a little tricky to make sure you know what's going on at all times. That's unfortunate. Significant incidental contact there. Two girls battling hard, skating hard, just ran into each other by accident. Hopefully she's okay. That's Guelph is number 66, Rose Williams. Looks like she probably got the air knocked out of her there a little bit, just trying to catch her breath. You never like to see it. These girls move so fast on the ice. They are so powerful, such strong skaters. When you run into each other by accident without being aware, it can cause a lot of damage. Good to see her up, moving on her own steam back to the bench. Brunette has so much strategy into it. Every chance you get the ring, all possession play, you're setting things up. How can you get people out of position? All Team Ontario would love to see happen here is Guelph to start chasing or get out of their triangle. Creates great scoring chances. That's another big accidental contact. Guelph was flying into the zone. And number three from Timo, Melissa Evans. She made a good defensive play, but she got her head down by accident, and I think she might have taken a knee to the head. So, unfortunate play for sure. Now, Melissa's up on her knees. She's just relaxing, hopefully catching her breath again. That's Sherry Markle out in the ice with her right now. Now, Sherry's the head coach, but she's also, you know, from everything I've heard, I've only met her a few times, she is one of the great ladies in ringette. You know, she's got a heart, the heart the size of this arena, and you can tell she's concerned about her player right now down there, making sure she's okay. Melissa Evans is one of the hometown girls here. Actually, Team Ontario is Waterloo, but we have got, there's three London girls playing on Waterloo right now, mostly for school. Carly Sutton, Melissa Evans, and Stephanie Singeris are all LRA players that, for one reason or the other, have moved on and joined the Waterloo team. Tremendous success with them this year. It's great to see London still being represented in the end game here, but obviously Team Waterloo is Team Ontario. Guelph has got to be a little tired. They played to a 5-4 overtime victory yesterday against Alberta 1 to be here today. So, you know, we had a chance to play in an overtime game this week, and it is grueling, grueling. When you've already played your 40 minutes of ringette at top speed, everything you had left on the ice, and you got to go out for one more. You know, these girls have definitely earned their spot here to play on Sunday by sticking with it and coming through with a win on yesterday's game against the Alberta 1 team. Playing ringette on the big ice surface like this is definitely a possession game. You got to control the ring, control the play, and both teams are doing a great job. Neither one are panicking. Both are doing controlled efforts. It makes for a much funner game to watch. Much more. Team Ontario team's calling for a two-line pass there. Looks like it might have deflected off someone in the middle of the ice. Guelph was on a fast break there. Great pass out of the zone from the neutral zone area into the breaking number six on Guelph. Kept her feet moving and drew a penalty there. So there'll be Timo will be shorthanded again. 2 minutes for hooking to number 16, Jesse Burke. A lot of people probably wonder why, when you're driving in the zone, girls off a spin off and just wait. All they want to do is make sure they have fresh legs on the ice. You got to keep possession in this game. And the more tired you are in your own zone or in the offensive zone, if something bad goes on and you're not taking a break, you're not getting a line change when you should, you'll get caught chasing back into your own area. Looks like Guelph got the shot off just in time before the shot clock went. And because it went anyways, they get possession of the ring back again. So, bit of a lucky break for Guelph. The momentum in this game has shifted two or three times already. Guelph's controlling the play and has for the last few minutes. The team has had plenty of chances as well. Quick shot. Now, some of these girls can fire the ring harder than some of these NHLers can fire a puck. The quick shots are the ones that usually score the goals. Justin Jarris has the ring. Nice, easy pass over the line. It's all about getting that ring into the offensive zone. She made a great decision, great choice, nice, easy pass.
Number
was number six from Team Guelph, streaking down. Nice top shelf shot, but just hit post, hit crossbar, and out it comes. But sometimes those breaks happen. Nice pass by Matty Flynn on number 15. Jordy Ahrens, just a little bit too quick to handle. That's the end of the first period. Team O versus Team Guelph in a 1-1 tie. And both teams 11 shots each. So we're lucky enough during halftime here to be joined by my friend Gwen Lidstad. Gwen got to be one of our lucky ambassadors this week. Gwen, what team were you with?
I was with the Quebec 2 team, which was BLL.
And that was with the U19 division?
Yes.
So did you watch them play either of these teams this week?
Actually, I watched them play both, and one of them twice.
One of them twice, wow. So how was the experience this week, Gwen?
It was great. They took me in like one of their family. They were always accepting. They helped me with rides, and I just hung out with them all week, and it was such a fun week with all of them that I would totally do it again if I ever got the opportunity.
Fantastic. So. What did you get a chance to do? Tell us a couple things specifically you got to do with the team. Did you go on the ice? Did you get to go for dinners? Did you stay at the hotel at all? What were the things you got to do?
Well, we played a bunch of card games at the hotel. They never excluded me from anything, which is great. We went out for dinner at Krabby Joe's yesterday, and they had like crock pots and stuff like that. We were just the food all around was amazing. It was just so much fun. I didn't go on the ice, but I went to all their practice and I went to all of their games to support them. And unfortunately, they didn't make it to the end, but I sure wish they did.
Well, hey, this is great. So I'll explain a little bit later on what the ambassadors are, but Gwen did a great job for London Ringette and being an ambassador for us as well as for the team. She took care of the team all week, was there cheering them on. Even when they were against the London team, she was cheering them on. So good for Gwen, and I'll talk to you about it later. Period two's on the way. Unfortunately, Team Ontario started off with an early penalty. Probably not the game plan they drew out on the board just a few moments ago. Stephanie Sinjaris is heading to the box for Team O. Stephanie's father is actually Phil Sinjaris, president of London Ringette. He probably taught her how to take penalties like that, I'm pretty sure anyways. These games are just flying by. The pace at which these guys are skating, these ladies are skating, the way they're making their passes, it's just fantastic to watch. Another opportunity for Team Guelph, flying in from the wing, making a nice cut to the triangle, and another crossbar for them. Number six on Guelph today is just flying out there. Teams are back at even strength. So far in the first 2.5 minutes of this period, Guelph has definitely controlled the play, controlled the game. Unfortunately, we haven't seen Melissa Evans come back out on the ice yet since that injury earlier in the first period. I hope she's okay. Penalty lead at number 15, 2 minutes for tripping. Here comes number six again for Guelph. In all alone, And she makes a great move and finishes it off. Oh, ref said it's a crease violation. Beat the goalie, but didn't beat the rules. Good thing the ref was right there to make that call. Refs are cheering for our opinion. Sorry, the fans are cheering for a call there. Refs are letting these girls play. Both teams have made some choices, but they definitely letting these girls play. Some good pressure from Team Ontario after that near miss from Team Guelph. Momentum swings so quickly in this game. That was number two, Maddie McLean, driving to the triangle again, making good things happen. Nice down low pass from Guelph, but Carly Sutton was there having none of that. Oh, see, quick shots. The quick shots are the ones that are almost beating the goalies here. The hard ones, they're getting right in their space. Oh, an unfortunate high sticking penalty coming in number eight on Team Ontario. Rachel Dickey went for the stick check and got face mask. Be a slashing call against Rachel Dickey. You know, these girls are playing so hard. Everything they're trying to do is so hard. A little slip like that, and unfortunately you get penalized, but it does happen. It's the rules of the game. Guelph is really working that low post scenario there. Carly Sutton, she's doing a good job reading it and getting from post to post to take it away. Oh, nice forecheck by Team Ontario, but Guelph does recover. Look at the speed from number nine on Team Ontario. Almost blew through the triangle there. Erin Markle, she was coming off the bench on a mission.
Yeah.
Bob is going for a line change, just settling things down in the offensive zone, waiting for support to come in. Oh, big save in tight on number 45, Team Guelph. He had a chance. Sorry, my correction, number 15. Anna Lawrence was in tight on Carly, and Carly kept her ground. Number 6 for Guelph is back on the ice. She has been absolutely everywhere tonight. Miss there, lots of deflection going on. Unfortunate. Bit of a miscommunication there on Team Ontario's part in their own end. Turns the ring back over to Guelph. Fresh legs are coming out for everybody though. It's interesting, every game, every team we've watched so far today, everybody's put a high forward out here trying to draw out the area. You'll see up here we've got the one forward and the one D. Creates a lot more space to get out of your own zone, but it's a consistent strategy used by all teams at this tournament that I've seen. Wow, that was probably a little too close for comfort right there. Quick shot again, number 20 on Guelph. She didn't waste any time. Neely Jarvis, quick shot. Almost beat Carly through a deflection. Right now, Team Guelph has got 20 shots to Team Ontario 16. It's been even almost all game, but right now it feels like the edge might be going to Team Guelph. Mo gained access to Guelph's area here. Oh, quick little pass from behind the net. Didn't quite work out. And Team Ontario's pressure causes the goalie to get to a 5 count. And they get to start fresh. Fresh legs, fresh strategy. Let's see what happens off this free play. Maybe we'll try to run a set play. Oh, that was a big save. Big save by the Guelph goaltender. There was so many moves happening there, I got confused, but she stuck with it the whole way and made sure that ring wasn't getting by. There from Waterloo, or from Team Ontario. The passing they do in close, within a few feet of each other, is incredible. How they can stab it, move it so quickly, with such confidence. Such a tight game. We're at 8 minutes left in the period, and we're tied at 1-1. Shots are 21-16 in favor of Guelph. Such a tight game. It's anybody's game still, absolutely. And we got a slashing call coming to Team Guelph. Number 89 for Team Guelph, Kelsey Hamilton. Just got her stick up where she shouldn't have. Timo sneaking in. They had a bit of a two-on-one right there, but the goalie read the non-pass, read the shot the whole way, took it away. Timo's got a full reset, full shot clock here in the end. See what they can do with using it. Oh, Guelph streaking in, and Carly makes a big save on number 10 from Guelph. Selena Case coming from the backwards of the defense position, all the way jumping up in there, but to no avail. See Timo going for a line change again. Fresh legs. They got possession in the zone. They're waiting for fresh legs to get out there. Oh, and a near miss on the far side. Another penalty coming against Team Guelph. Number 66 is heading to the box. Rose Williams is heading to the box for Guelph. 2 minute penalty. And Timo just kept their feet moving. They never stopped and they're drawing penalties now. Snuck through, but Carly got her feet, so you got her legs squeezed there just in time. Again, if you notice, that was another really quick shot that almost made the goalie. Now that was a fancy move. That was number 7 from Team O. If she had pulled that off, Amy Burke, if you pulled that off, it would have been something for TSN's highlight of the night for sure. Streaking in. It's a 2-on-1 right now. Oh, and they just settle down, set up, get fresh legs on the ice, controlling the tempo, controlling the pace. Guelph is still out shooting Team Ontario, 24-20 right now, with 2 minutes and 40 seconds left in the game. Timo's looking for the simple passes to get entry to the zone. Not looking for anything fancy. Getting the fresh legs out there, get flying. Oh, and a nice kick save by Samantha Gorgel, Team Guelph's goalie. She's actually played a great game so far. Made a big difference to her team. What you just saw there was number 11, Cass Speak, making sure nothing was getting through. That was a great defensive play. That was all upper body strength to make sure that shot didn't happen. Great job. Great back check by Maddie McLean to stop that. Uh-oh. 4 in the zone, Team Ontario. Guelph's ring. We're down to almost our last minute of play here. A minute and 5 seconds left in this period. Team Guelph, right off the free play. Quick shot, snuck through Carly. Unfortunate, Carly's made some huge saves for this team today. But that one just snuck through. The team's got, Team Ontario has a minute and 2 to get this game tied back up. Team O just called a timeout. It's gonna reset. The coaches are cool and calm, you can see them. That's where the girls are going to read off of, right? The girls are going to read off of that. 62 seconds left in this period. Number six, Madison Seagram from Guelph, scored that goal to put Guelph ahead 2-1. Goal has been open. It's been open for the last few minutes. They're trying to sneak through here and make something happen. But Guelph is just standing up like a wall. Looks like a goal ring going back to them. Got 14.1 seconds left in the game. And the Guelph goalie makes the chase out of the zone. Oh. What a hard-fought battle. What a heartbreaker. Just over a minute left in the game, and Guelph sneaks a goal in. Both teams deserve to be proud, or should be proud of themselves. They played great games. In a ringette, to have a game ended at 2-1, something to be said about the defensive prowess and the goaltending in both games. They both tried hard. They both gave it everything they had. And lots to learn from, lots of memories here. You can see Guelph just celebrating like crazy right now. Obviously, they battled hard all weekend. Like I said, won in overtime yesterday to even get to this game. So kudos to them. Well-deserved, well-fought battle. And Timo, you can't see them right now on camera, but they are huddled in a sign of unity. They couldn't be any closer right now. I'm sure it's heartbreaking, but man, are they showing resilience as a team. It's an amazing sight to see. Nepean Ravens are coming on, or sorry, I apologize, the Alberta Team 1, Team Alberta, has come on the ice to join these two teams as they won their bronze medal game 6-3 over Nepean. So that'll be Team Alberta getting the bronze today. They're coming out on the ice in the blue. Thank you. We are doing the medal ceremony right now, so there'll be some individual awards, and then of course the awarding of the championship trophy. Individual team. Individual award for Team Ontario is going to number 14, Tara. If you were watching this game, you saw her heart be poured out on that ice. She skated from one end to the other with a fire and fury. It was a fantastic thing to watch. Number six, Madison Thibault from Guelph Predators, Individual Achievement Award. Again, I mentioned her more than once. She was amazing out there. Whether the goals went in or not, she was in both ends dominating the ice surface. Defensive play, number one, to the goalie for Guelph Predators. She played great. Every shot she faced, she was there. You know, nothing more you can say about her effort today. It was fantastic. Look at the smile on her face. Good for her. One of the things that not everybody may know is that this is to be a very special time for a lot of these girls. When you get to U19, a lot of girls make other choices, and they also, that's the last year of organized youth ringette. So the third year of U19, which I know that for Team Waterloo, for sure, there's more than a handful of girls that may not be back playing youth. Now, hopefully they continue on in some other way and open or embracing the sport in some way. But this is a big moment for a lot of these girls. So, yes, the game was important for the result, but it's also very important for what they've done for the sport or how much of their life they've designated to it. So, big emotional memory for all of them.
Michelle.